Lieutenant General Serelito Sobejana formally takes over as the new Chief of Staff of the Armed Forces of the Philippines as Gilbert Gapay retires. In a turnover ceremony last night in Malacañang, President Rodrigo Duterte expressed full confidence in the new head of the AFP. And General Sobejana joins us this morning. Good morning to you, General Sobejana.
Good morning, Ma'am Karen, at maraming salamat.
Well, first of all, congratulations to you. I know that the turnover ceremonies, you gave a speech yesterday. What is your first order of the day as AFP chief?
Well, ma'am, immediately after the turnover yesterday, we had our first command conference. And in that command conference, I give my guidance. My guidance is guidance was just a continuation of what had been started by my predecessors. We had been working on as a public servant, primarily in securing the land and or securing the people and defending the territory. So ang dinagdag ko lang po, ma'am, is with us fighting insurgency and terrorism for 5 decades now, I highlighted that we should come up with our quick wins and catch-up plans so that we can say that or we can put an end to the menace of terrorism and insurgency. And we have to take advantage of the mechanism at hand, particularly the EU 70, wherein it calls for a whole-of-the-nation approach. So, ibig sabihin, we have recognized that security is a shared responsibility. Everybody in the government should take part, and even the community sector or the civilian sector or the community as a whole should even be involved in our peace and security efforts.
But in your speech yesterday, General, you also vowed that the military will respect human rights, follow the rule of law, and strictly adhere to the provisions of the international humanitarian.
Yes, ma'am. Essentially, that is our those are our operational imperatives. We do our job following the rule of law. Kaya, all soldiers should be knowledgeable on the existing laws, because there's a saying that ignorance of the law excuses no one. So yun po, ma'am, ang binibigyan natin ng halaga to educate our people kung ano yung mga existing laws. And of course, we also have to give due respect to human rights. We are public servants. Our primary clients or customers are the civilians. So kailangan...
Okay, you made that clear. So you made that clear, no? Our customers are the civilians. We need to respect human rights. I want to ask you the latest controversy coming from the military. The military has been in hot water for a red tagging, coming up with an erroneous list. And yesterday, General Parlade actually said and called the Inquirer reporter, Tech Torres Tupaz, a propagandist. And he said that she aids terrorists. Will you tolerate what General Parlade said?
Ma'am, we need to look back, no, kung ano yung mga erroneous thing na nangyayari or the mistakes that we have committed. And we should draw lessons from that. So henceforth, ma'am, my instruction was that whenever we talk or whatever things we do, we should be very deliberate. We should exercise due diligence. Para sa ganon, magkaroon tayo ng, makapagbigay tayo ng magandang servisyo sa ating mga kababayan. We should not hurt anybody unless he is the enemy of the state. So we have to really properly identify the enemies of the state, as what I've said, so that walang collateral damage and so on. So rest assured, ma'am, na magiging deliberate kami sa aming mga ginagawa.
Okay, so do you also consider Inquirer reporter Tech Torres Tupaz an enemy of the state? Because General Parlade said she was a propagandist and accused her of aiding terrorists. So in effect, based on his sentence, without saying she's an enemy of the state, if someone aids a terrorist under the anti-terror law, that would make you an enemy of the state. So do you consider the Inquirer reporter an enemy of the state?
Ma'am, we will validate the statement. We will discuss about it. Then we will present to the public whatever evidences that we are able to gather. Kung ano man yung magiging resulta sa investigation namin.
Okay, so you are saying you will investigate Parlades' statements against the Inquirer reporter?
Not necessarily investigating General Parlades, ma'am, but we have to investigate or validate about the involvement of anybody, no? Not necessarily Inquirer, pero it applies to all. As what I've said,
yes,
we
but
will
then,
exercise
General, General, yeah, General, I understand that you're being very, you're looking at this from a macro perspective, but this is a live situation in front of you, wherein you have General Parlades already accusing a reporter, a media practitioner from a mainstream newspaper of aiding terrorists. And the question is, will military officers get away with this? He accused Angel Locsin in the past, also Liza Soberano, although that's a closed book. So the question is, you said in your speech, we will respect human rights, follow the rule of law, and adhere to the provisions of international humanitarian law. And under that law, you don't accuse media personnel of aiding terrorists without evidence. So my question is, will you investigate Parlades' statements?
Ma'am, please allow us to do the internal processes and we will inform you accordingly on the result of our efforts. And I would like to just make clear, ma'am, that the Armed Forces of the Philippines has its designated spokesperson, and that is Major General Ed Arevalo. And General Parlades is the designated spokesperson of NTF LCAC. So I could not tell him directly in his capacity as the spokesperson of NTF LCAC. But if Major General Arevalo made that statement, then I immediately I can correct him. I can correct him, especially if there are no concrete basis of his statement.
Bo. Ano lang, sir, it's not Arevalo who made the statement, it was General Parlades.
Can you come again, ma'am?
Bo. It was General Parlades of NTF LCAC who actually called the Inquirer reporter a propagandist and one who was aiding terrorists.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
So, as the spokesperson of NTF.
Okay. All right. If hypothetically there was a mistake, would you demand an apology?
Well, ma'am, if that's the case, then we should.
Okay, so if that's the case, we should. When it comes to red tagging, what will be the military stand? Are there changes when it comes to red tagging practices of the military under your leadership, General?
As what I've said, ma'am, and I would like to reiterate, gawin namin, ma'am, yung aming trabaho in a very deliberate manner. We should be very extra careful, lalo na sa pagsasalita. We should be very accurate in determining the enemies of the state. Kasi ma'am, I do believe that for us to win this war, we should not just make ourselves bigger, but make the enemy smaller. So it's better to gain friends than creating enemies. Besides, we are mandated to serve the people. So we should not... we should not appear as the enemy of the people.
Okay, we should not appear as the enemy of the people. So yesterday also the defense secretary met with UP, an initial meeting regarding the abrogation of the UP-DND accord. I wanted to ask you, General, your own personal views when it comes to this. How do you feel about the military? What will you order your men when it comes to entering the UP campus? Would you inform the UP chancellor or the dean, or without the accord, do you believe that soldiers can come in freely at any time?
Ma'am, una-una, there was a dialogue yesterday being done with the Secretary of National Defense, Secretary Delphine Lorenzana, and the UP management. It's a work in progress. There will be a succeeding dialogues. Hanggang mag-settle tayo to a win-win. Then, as your question whether the military should just can freely enter into UP campuses, may it be in Diliman or in other campuses across the country. Ma'am, I hope everybody understands that our mandate is to serve the people and secure the land. And considering that UP is a public domain, we should not be prevented from going into this into that place if there's a call for us to perform our duty.
And when you say there's a call for us to perform our duty, do you mean that you would still want prior coordination with the school?
Yes, ma'am. Para kang nang pagpumasok ka sa isang tahanan, you have to knock on the door of the owner of the house. And but if there's a crime ongoing, then we have to immediately come in para yung mabitigate yung effect ng krimen na nangyayari at masave natin yung kailangang iligtas.
Now, before we go, General Sobejana, you are the 9th Chief of Staff of the President. You have a stellar track record, frankly. You're considered a living hero. You were awarded the Medal of Valor. But this, I mean, this is not an easy feat to achieve. So just to remind our viewers, no, they may not know your history. You're known for the battle against 150 Abu Sayyaf armed group terrorists. In 1995, you led that unit. 42 Abu Sayyaf members died. But you are only 6 months as AFP chief. What do you hope to achieve when it comes to neutralizing real terrorists? You said that is your goal, to neutralize real terrorists.
Ma'am, with a limited time, we have to have a catch-up plan and quick wins. And I would like to impress upon the public that our campaign had started long time ago. In fact, we have been fighting this insurgency and terrorism for 50 years now. So this is not just the start of the campaign. Ang gagawin ko is the continuation of the campaigns being done by my predecessors. That's why during my term, I have to come up with a very concrete catch-up plan and quick win approaches. So I could not divulge to the public kung ano man yon, for obvious reason. But rest assured, ma'am, I will not make any promises, but rest assured, I will do my best effort to make things happen.
You also said that there's a need to address the gaps when it comes to intelligence gathering in the military. Ano ang kailangan po ng militar?
Well, ma'am, I'm sorry. I could not divulge our intelligence capability right now for obvious reason, but we have identified our gaps and we will try our best effort to fill in those gaps so that we can easily find and fix the enemies of the state so that our combat units can do direct actions very deliberately without collateral damage.
What is the priority of the AFP under your watch, sir? Is it, do you consider the Communist Party, communist elements as the real threat, or do you consider really terrorists in Mindanao like the Abu Sayyaf group as your priority in the 6 months?
We treat all the threat groups of equal importance. But of course, as you have, what you have said, with a limited time, I need to prioritize. Yeah. And my priority is to put an end to the menace of terrorism. So LTGMAM will be our priority, but without looking aside to our efforts against the CTGs. So there will be a sustained momentum in as far as our campaign against the CTGs is concerned, but giving more focus on LTGs.
Okay, you do have some sectors, actually, I've spoken to some who were optimistic about your leadership when it comes to red tagging issues now coming from the military. Is there a closing message you would like to give when it comes to the issue on red baiting and red tagging?
Well, ako'y nananawagan sa ating mga kababayan na ang inyong armed forces are remain committed and dedicated to do their job as protector of the people and the defender of the territory. We consider the public as our primary customer and the beneficiaries of our efforts. As what I've said, it's better to gain friends than creating enemies. And having said that, in everything we do, may it be in publications or actions against the enemies of the state or the threat groups, we will exercise, and I would like to reiterate, due diligence and be deliberate in doing our job.
Huli ko na lang, General, would you also caution the military from red tagging and red baiting journalists or the media?
Yes, ma'am. That's one of my highlights in my guidance yesterday. That we should be very careful. Kasi the body of truth ay nasa sa atin kung we just, if we took a lot. Na wala tayo pinanghawakan na mga ebidensya.
All right. On that note, General Sobejana, well, good luck to you, sir. And we wish you success in your leadership in the 6 months.
Maraming salamat, ma'am.